Hi, my name is Andrei Yakovenko with Neuromain Training. In this brief video, we're going to discuss how to design your training program. We already had a little video about talking about the frequency. Perhaps if you stay in home, you know, during this time of isolation, you know, typically we would recommend doing it this kind of, you know, form of high intensity strength training a couple times a week, maybe even sometimes once a week. But that's when we do it here, when you actually have a good quality equipment and we are personally coaching you to true failure, then your body will need that kind of 3-5 days recovery. Staying home is different, you're gonna push in yourself. So luckily or not, you won't need that much recovery. So for your purpose, you know, you probably should do it, you know, every other day. Do workout one day, give your body a rest for one day and repeat it. So you do about maybe three workouts a week. Now, how to, what do you want to do? So let's say you do three times. Let's say you do Monday upper body, and then Wednesday you're going to do lower, and then Friday you're going to do upper. And then the following week you're going to do lower, upper, lower. So basically each time is going to alternate. The upper is going to be followed by lower, lower is going to be upper, and then we're going to alternate, and, you know, giving our body, our muscles, sufficient recovery time. So let's say you do an upper body. In those videos, you will see there are five different variations for the push-ups, from more intense to less intense. So perhaps choose, you know, couple or more pushing exercise, like one of the push-up exercises, and do one or two for the shoulders. Perhaps do those two shoulder exercises you can do. Then for the back, we recommend doing a little bit more for the back, just because, you know, our lifestyle is such that we kind of lose strength in the back. So followed by bad posture and, you know, aches and pains in upper back and so on and so forth. So you should be doing, if you're doing, you know, two, three, like a pushing exercises, like chest press, maybe one or two variations, you know, shoulders, maybe, you know, one or two variations, do more for the back. Do most of the back exercise that we posted. There should be probably at least five different variations, but at least do at least three. Do a pull down, do row, do, you know, do the rhomboids. So do at least three back exercises. Now on your, and you know, so your workout might be in total somewhere between, you know, I would say 5 to 8 exercises for the upper body. If it's 10, it's great. Now on the lower body day, where you're gonna be working your legs and core, do there is like one ab exercise, there's a hip thrust exercise for your glutes and your hamstrings, do those. You can do a wall squat, you can do a body squat, you can do those negative one unilateral single leg squats as well. You don't have to do all of them, but, you know, at least do, I would say, maybe 2, 3, 4 legs, and then do the core one and the hip thrust. And then on Friday, you know, repeat your routine. There should be enough variation to keep it interesting. You don't have to do all the variations. Just pick and choose whichever you want to do, and then the following week, you would start with slower, do the same exercises and upper. So you don't have to change exercises every time. The thing is, during the first 4 to 8 weeks, most of your strength is not gonna come from morphological muscle fiber adaptations. Your muscles are really not gonna get much stronger due to their, you know, increase in fiber size. What's gonna happen, you're neurologically gonna become more efficient. Your body is gonna learn first how on a neurological level to be more efficient in that movement. So don't rush changing those exercises. Design a routine and stick with this routine for at least, you know, during this home state, 2-3 months, I would say. And after a couple months, maybe more, maybe 3 months, change the routine a little bit, change the variations, and keep it fresh. Now, when you perform the actual exercises, if your heart rate is important for you, if your cardiovascular fitness matters to you, you wanna don't just want to work your muscle, you want to actually improve your cardiovascular fitness, keep the break between each of the sets, each of the exercises, to less than 30 seconds. Should be like maybe 15 seconds. So you basically, you finished one, catch a breath, go start another one right away. So that way, your break between the exercises is going to be 15 seconds or so. And you're going to perform the whole workout, whatever number of exercises that could be, somewhere between, you know, 6 and 10, and it really shouldn't take you more about 20-30 minutes max to complete, sometimes maybe even 15 minutes to complete your workout. And believe me, if you do it right, you're gonna feel really, really, really exhausted, and you're gonna need that recovery. Don't do something the next day, because now during the exercise, what you achieved, you created the stimulus for adaptation. Now your body needs time to recover, rest, invest in the new metabolic tissue, new lean muscle tissue, that takes energy and time. So don't keep breaking your muscle and gain the next day. Give your body at least 48 hours before you do this workout again. And then again, don't do, if you did upper, don't do upper again, do lower. And then give it 48 hours and do upper, and then alternate it that way. As far as recording your progress goes, what you need to record the date. You need to make a spreadsheet of all the exercises and variation you're gonna do. There's videos for all those variations. So pick and choose which one you're gonna do. You're gonna record for the most exercises, use a stopwatch on your phone, how many seconds it took you to reach what you called momentary muscular failure on the positive phase of the exercise. That phase where you're trying to contract muscle and you couldn't contract it anymore. Then you note the time under tension. And then on top of it, you're gonna do the 30 second negative. If it took you less than 30 seconds, it's great. A little bit more is great as well. So what you're gonna record number of seconds it took you to reach, you know, positive momentary muscular failure on that, when you couldn't contract muscles anymore. And then you're gonna note how many seconds you were able to do that negative. Did you do, was it 30 seconds, was it 15, and so on. So that kind of will give you an idea of your progress when you do it the following day. Are you able to do a little bit more than the previous time? Now, this is not the whole story as far as your progress goes. Keep in mind our three guiding principles. If your form was not good, all that you recorded is meaningless, right? It only matters if you had a good quality form. So record your form, you know, 1, 2, 3. Three best form, you know, one worst form. If it was perfect form, you've prioritized the muscle of the movement, give yourself three. How was your second principle? Where you maintain slow and controlled cadence, keeping the muscle under tension. Again, rank yourself from 1 to 3. Three best, one worst. Give yourself a number. Did you go to failure? Meaning, did you reach the failure on the positive stroke? And did you go for the 30 second negative where you couldn't perform, you know, another inch in a perfect form, even if your life depended on it? And mark yourself, 1, 2, 3. This is what you're gonna record for each exercise. And why it matters is when you look at your record, the next time you're doing those exercises, you're gonna look at your time, you're gonna look what you did, you're gonna look at your time under load, and you're gonna look at those three principles. If those three principles, not all of them three, keep focusing on what you're doing. You're not ready to, you know, do more advanced version or something like that. Keep track of your quality of the exercise as well, not just how many seconds it took you. Because if you had, you know, frankly shitty form, it doesn't matter if it took you, you know, 3 minutes or like 90 seconds. What it matters is really those three principles. Never break those three principles. Follow them. And that's, you know, pretty much it as far as approaching this training. If you have any more questions, you can go to our website at newelementtraining.com. You could send us an email with any questions at info@newelementtraining.com, or perhaps if you want to book an online coaching session, send us an email at info@newelementtraining.com, and we can help you there. Thank you.